Dear friends in Christ, we are in the fourth Sunday of Advent. It's almost Christmas. The crib is on, the gifts are ready and wrapped, the lights are lit, the stars are burning. But our hearts, are they? Can we move from almost to the real Christmas? The call is to move from the externals to the heart of this event, that is, Christ. The readings of this Sunday can help us in this journey to Christ. The first reading of today is from Prophet Micah. His prophecies are mostly against injustice and corrupt practices that were prevalent in his time. His teachings are in the line of his predecessors like Prophet Amos, Hosea, etc. But here, the portion of this day's reading is one of promise of the Messiah. The time is probably towards the end of the exile. The reading describes the time of the Savior and ends with the words, "He shall be peace." And we know nothing else can really bring us this divine gift of peace. In our pain, trials and longings, let us know that He shall be our peace. Let's move to make Him born in our hearts, and this peace shall be ours. The second reading from the letter to the Hebrews speaks about the supreme obedience of Jesus to the will of the Father. In one single word, it sums up the entire salvation event. Behold, I have come to do your will. I'm sure all of us like to order and command. To be subjected to and to obey calls for a greater degree of humility and integrity. I've always wondered which would have been more acceptable to the Father from Jesus, his obedience to the Father's plan or his event of the sacrifice. Of course, the two are one and the same. But if we separate them for a minute, I believe it was his obedience that found more take before the Father. Then here is a personal call and challenge to each of us. Do I find it difficult to obey and do God's will, duties asked of me by my elders, my spouse, rules of my profession, and so on? The model is Jesus, God's own Son, before us. We know that only in humility can I submit myself to obedience. And when there is humility in my heart, all virtues can grow, and the devil fears most those with this virtue in abundance. The Gospel from St. Luke is a scene of the Visitation. Mary running in haste to be by the side of her cousin Elizabeth. There are a lot of reflections that we can arrive at by reading and looking into this event. Let me pick up three words from this incident. In haste. The journey is in hurry and the distance is long. The purpose is to serve. How is me? Do I move to serve others in haste, or is it with always reluctance? Mary enters and greets. The meeting was also the bringing of the Spirit. Her presence brought God's Spirit to Elizabeth. Does God have the most important place in our meetings, relationships, and union? If so, the Spirit will bind us stronger. If not, sin and the evil one will divide and destroy our union. Joy. There's an expression of joy in both, and the reason is divine. God alone is the one who can give us this joy and sustain us always in it. Now let us look at Mary, the Mother of God. She conceived him and carried him to Elizabeth. In my life too, these two events need to happen. To have him within and also to witness him to another. And Mary can teach us best to do it. These are the two dimensions of the Christian living of faith. Having Jesus and sharing Him. Mary makes the journey to a distant place in faith with the Lord. That is our calling. In our life's long journey, we are asked to be with the Lord and to travel on. And we are not alone. We need to carry Him along. And Mary, our mother, can be the best accompaniment as we go home. As we come to the close of this season and the event of Christmas, let's pray that our hearts be ready to have Him within. And may our Blessed Mother and Saint Joseph prepare us best to receive Him. God bless you. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.